ready. Y'all want to hear how my story was when I went to jail? Y'all want a quick little story time? All right. So this is what happened when I went to jail. All right. I flew home, right? I flew home to shoot my music video to a song called Storyteller, I mean, right? It's called Storyteller. It's like a rock and roll song, right? I flew home just to shoot the music video to this. I was on tour with Kevin Gates. I flew home and I'm in my Lamborghini. The music video shoot was in Compton. Compton got nice venues and pier spaces where you can get like big ass warehouses to shoot at, right? So I'm like, oh, you said save it for the podcast. It's cool. I can talk about it twice. Fuck it. I went to I'm in a Lamborghini, right? And I'm going maybe like 80 miles per hour. Going about 80 miles per hour. I'm not going to lie. It doesn't matter at this point because the case is completely dismissed. But I'm going 80 miles per hour trying to get to this place. Before I left my house, I made sure I grabbed my gun because I'm like, I'm going to Compton. I'm in a Lamborghini. I don't have my Escalade at this point in time. Like, nowadays, bro, you don't see me in luxury cars unless I'm in the nicest area in LA. Like, I might have drove past one of you in LA and y'all don't know because I ride low key. Think I'm an Uber these days. You feel me? So I'm riding a Lamborghini. This is before I had a low key whip and I get flicked. I get pulled over or whatever. Right. They pull me over. I'm like, fuck, I got to get to my music video shoot. Mind you, I paid for this music video shoot. Everything's fully paid for. I get pulled over. I'm like on a 5. If you know where that's at in LA, I'm on a 5. I'm like Van Nuys or some shit, right? I pull over. The cop take me out the car. I'm like, damn, why y'all take me out the car? Nigga take me out the car, handcuff me and everything. I'm like, bro, what's going on? They was like, can you tell us if you have a weapon in the car before we look? That's how they got me. They said, before we look, they got me. And I snitched on myself. Now, I've never been arrested before or detained or whatever you call it. That never happened to me before. So I'm thinking like, damn, like these niggas must have seen some or something. My stupid ass tell them, yeah, I got a gun in the car, but it's mine. Now, y'all don't know about L.A. laws. They laws is retarded. I ain't gonna say that word. They laws is dumb. You feel me? Like, even if a gun is completely registered to you, even if it's like 100% yours, I bought this weapon at a store. I have my license. I don't have my CCW, but I have my license for it. It's mine. It's registered under my name. It's not a fucking, I ain't got nothing illegal on it. It's all regulated. I got the shit out the store, all that shit, right? So I tell him, yeah, I got something. The nigga, when I told him, the nigga looked at me like, in his eyes, he be like, you dumbass nigga. That's what it looked like in his eyes. Cause I'm like, cause he, what he told me was, he was like, you can tell us if you got something in the car or we're just going to impound it if we can't search it. I had my Cuban link chains in the car and shit. So I'm like, I'm going to just tell him cause I don't want you to impound it. And then somebody at the impound take my $70,000 car. I mean, $70,000 chain. So I told him that I had it, right? This bitch ass nigga takes me to jail, bro. So I had to call my mama. She had to come get my Lamborghini. These niggas put me in the back of the fucking police car. Now, the back of a police car, if you've ever been arrested before, is very, very uncomfortable. I'm sitting on my damn hands. The cuffs is too tight. My hands is getting red and shit. Mind you, y'all, I think I have ADHD because I get bored very, very, very quickly. Like, if I'm not doing nothing, I'm on my phone. I'm looking up something. I'm posting something. I'm always on my phone or I'm always doing something, right? So I'm in the back of the police car. And I'm just staying calm because I'm like, bro, it ain't no way I'm really finna get locked up. It's these niggas have to let me out this bitch, right? So they take me to the station, right? They put me in a holding cell, okay? Now, this is not even like the actual police station or it's not the actual jail. I'm sitting in there, right? They like, oh, are you a rapper? Blah, blah, blah. You know Blueface? I was like, yeah. Like, yeah, ooh. Then they was like, oh, it's okay, bro. You'll be all right, bro. You'll be good, bro. It's not that serious, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, all right, cool. I'm sitting there for about 30 minutes. Mind you, I'm looking at a wall. I'm in there by myself. I'm staring at a fucking white wall for 30 minutes while they take my fingerprints and all this other shit, right? Then they take me out. A police officer tells me to go in the bathroom and pull my pants down and cough. I'm like, all right, y'all niggas doing too much. So I'm no homo, bro. I'm literally squatting, coughing. Like, what am I going to do? Have a knife in my, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to put a knife up my ass or something. You know what I'm saying? Say, I'm like, all right. So I do the little coughing, little drill or whatever. Boom, I get out of there, right? Then they take me out of the police station, put me back in the car. At this point, I'm like, damn, like, y'all might as well talk to me at this point, be my homies, nigga. Like, nigga, y'all taking me from police station to jail. I'm riding around with these niggas like we homies or some shit. So they take me out of the car. They take me to the police station, right? I get out the car. They take me inside the jail. They put me in another cell, right? I'm sitting in a cell. It's hard-ass metal seat. The holding cell is literally probably as big as your closet, nigga. And not a walk-in closet. A little-ass closet that got one bar at the top. That's how big it is. And I'm sitting on this hard-ass metal thing, right? So I'm sitting there chilling, right? An hour passed. Mind y'all, no phone, no nothing, nobody to talk to. It's just me. An hour passed. I'm pissed as fuck. The main reason why I'm mad is because I only flew home because I wanted to shoot my music video. I'm on tour right now, y'all. I only flew home because I wanted to shoot my music video. I paid $20,000 to shoot this scene. Like, I really believed in the song. The song ended up not doing shit. So I really went to jail for no reason. But I go home, shoot the music video. That's what I came for. So I'm mad because I got to reshoot whenever I get out of jail. So the nigga walk in, he be like, oh, it's good, bro. It's not that serious. I took my mug shots and everything. I'm glad my mug shots never came out because I was not happy. Niggas would have been saying I was sad or some shit. I was not happy in my mug shot at all. So I'm thinking like, damn, these niggas gonna see my mug shot, all this shit going through my head, right? I'm sitting down. The nigga, this fat ass police officer coming there, and he like, you're going to, it's all good, bro. Like, you should be out of here in the next 20 minutes. I'm like, all right, bet. Mind you, no one knows I'm in jail except my mom. She knows I'm in jail, but I don't have a cell phone. When you go to jail, they take all your shit. They take your cell phone, take your chains, take your gun, whatever, right? They put it and lock it all up, right? So I'm sitting there chilling for the 20 minutes that he said it was going to take for me to get out. And he come back in with a pink paper, be like, oh, no, they got you for another charge, so you're going to have to stay overnight. I said, what? Are you serious? So I'm like, okay. At this point, I'm like genuinely mad because I really spent money. I'm thinking I'm going to get out of jail in time and still be able to go shoot my video, and everything was going to be cool, right? They tell me I'm going to stay in there. I'm thinking like, and mind you, bro, the niggas that's in the jail, niggas that's in jail, bro, they're not having, okay? Like, I'm not no bougie nigga or nothing, but like, bro, the niggas I'm in jail around is like when you go to jail, bro, you're a nobody. I don't care how much money you got. I don't care how rich you is. I don't care how popular you are. Bro, when you go to jail, you're a nobody. You're just a human. That's it. No status I had, no nothing held any weight in jail, right? Which that's how it's supposed to be. They take me out of the holding cell, right? That's big as your closet. And then they tell me to walk over, right? These niggas give me a blanket and a pillow. And they say, this is your bed. They put me in a cell. They give me a granola bar. I remember it was a chocolate granola bar It was a Nature Valley chocolate granola bar. Shit was fire, I'm not gonna lie. It was good. I was hella hungry. They gave me a granola bar, they gave me a pillow, and they gave me a blanket, and then they gave me four free calls, or two or three free calls on the call phone. And they like, once you run out of these calls, you don't get no more. I'm like, what the fuck you mean, nigga? What if my mama don't answer? What if somebody else don't answer? And I'm stuck in jail. Then what? Like, that don't even make sense. How y'all gonna limit how many calls I can get, right? So I'm in there with like 6 or 7 drunk Mexican niggas. Niggas is like yelling in the cell, all types of shit. Doing all types of weird ass drunk shit. And at this point, it's like 1 in the morning. So I call my mom. My mom don't answer the first call. But she seen me go to jail. I call my mom. She don't answer the first call. I call my manager at the time. He answered. And I'm telling them, like, I'm damn near wigging on these niggas. I'm like, bro, get me out of fucking jail, bro. Like, why am I still in jail? I'm like, sick. I'm like, bro, why the fuck am I in jail? Like, nigga, get me out of jail. So I'm like snapping or whatever, right? That phone call in. I try to make another call. I don't remember my brother number. Can't call him. Boom, boom, boom. I just give up at that point, right? So I'm like, I'm just standing there. I'm just sitting in my bed. Mind you, the bed is literally a metal slab. It's no type of mattress, no type of nothing. It's just a cover, a pillow, and a metal slab. You literally sitting on a bell. I mean, sitting on a metal slab, right? So I end up putting my pillow down. I get my cover. I get my Nature Valley bar, and I just lay down. And I was just looking at the ceiling, listening to these drunk niggas make noises and shit, and they sleep. Then I finally go to sleep, and I'm mad as fuck. I'm pissed off. I wasted my money for the video. And then I go to sleep, right? I'm thinking at this point, like, damn, like, you know, if you get past like the 10, 11 hour mark, nigga, that's when they throw you the clothes, nigga. They give you the little jumpsuit and shit, and you really get locked up in like jail. 10 hours later, I wake up, they knock on the cell, they call my name and say it's time to go. I get my stuff, I walk out, and my brother, W Dub, in the chat, he bailed me out. So I get bailed out, and I think my bail was like something crazy, like $30,000 or something like that. But it was only $3,000. I gave him the money back, obviously, because it wasn't his fault that I got locked up. So you only got to pay 10% of your bail. So I get bailed out. I leave the police station. And after that, that same little case that I had goes on for 2 years. Like, I have real problems with it. I remember I flew into, where did I go? I flew into Australia to do some club hostings. And I got stopped at the border. Like, they took me to the back, questioned me a bunch of times. I flew to Paris. They almost didn't let me through. When you go out of state, like, all of this shit was on my record. And I finally got it dismissed 2 years later. Dimitri got it dismissed. If y'all know Dimitri, is my old manager, because he a lawyer too. So he got it dismissed for me. And you know, that's what happened. Took 2 years. And I always like to have a moral of the story when I tell y'all stories like this. Don't go to jail, bro. Don't go to jail. Don't do it. Because you will spend a lot of money, legal fees. You will get denied entry in certain countries. It does follow you. So don't go to jail. That's the moral of the story. Stay out of jail. Be a good boy, nigga. It ain't cool to be street. Okay? I know some people watching this, right? I got a lot of street supporters. Road man is what they say in London. It's a lot of YNs that look up to me. I'm telling y'all, stay out the streets. Okay? It's less money in the streets than it is in the real world. That's the goal. The goal ain't the Swiss cheese, niggas. The goal is to get the cheese. Okay? So, y'all stay out of trouble. I promise you, you'll be way happier outside of jail than in prison or in jail. And you'll make way more money out of the streets. I don't care how much you got for that dime bag or that pound you flipped. I guarantee you, the legal money is much more. So let's sit our ass down and figure it out. Okay? We get it. You can kill niggas. I can kill a nigga too. Everybody can. Everybody can Swiss cheese everybody. Literally, everybody can Swiss cheese anybody. That doesn't take any effort. Okay? All you need is a Swiss cheeser. If you get you a Swiss cheeser, then you can Swiss cheese anybody. It's not hard to just... That's all you got to do. All you got to do... This, all you need is this little tiny finger. That takes zero effort. Right? But who cares?